This is good assignment, but it's hard to read. How much does accounting for rotational energy matter? Consider allowing a hollow cylinder to roll down a ramp that flattens out at the end, heading to the ledge that is some height above the ground. This is some height above the ground. Suppose you start the cylinder from the rest at the top of the ramp. The rotational inertia of the cylinder rotating around its central axis is mR squared. Compare how far you would predict the cylinder lands horizontally from the ledge when you take into account that it rolls without slipping. Versus if you just treat it as though it slides down the ramp without rolling. You have rolling and sliding. You need ratio of distance that will reach while it roll or while it just slide. Give answer is ratio, when it's rolling, when it's sliding, when it's rolling neglected. So you have some, what is this, cylinder here. First time you will let it roll, and it will roll without slippage, and it will roll, come to this point, and it will come to this point here. In other case, it will not roll, it will just slip from here to here, and it will go this far. And we need to find what is the ratio between those two distances. Okay. Just ratio. We don't have anything else. We don't even have H2 and H1. Okay, but we need to find ratio of distances with rolling and without rolling. Okay. So, what energy will body with that cylinder have in this point? Energy of this cylinder in this point will be same as the potential energy difference between those two points. So you have mg. So potential energy difference, let's say delta PE, potential energy, here is some mgh2 minus, and here is mgh1 or mgh2 minus h1. If you don't have that, doesn't matter. We just try to, so this difference in potential energy between those two points, or just PA, I'll just call that PA in this assignment, that potential energy in the first case, when you have rolling, it will go into two things. One thing is in translational motion of that object, and second thing is in rotation. So that energy will have two parts. One part is translation energy, and other part is rotational energy. When it rotates, when it does not rotate, all this potential energy difference from these two points, or PA, will go into translation energy. So that's why when you don't rotate, you will go further. Okay, let us see how to calculate this. Okay, this is the equation for horizontal launch. We will not derive this. This is somewhat standard range of the horizontal launch when you have initial velocity in horizontal direction and you have height, you are on the surface of the planet Earth. This is the equation for that. It's not too difficult to calculate, but doesn't matter. So this is the range when you have horizontal launch. In this case, this h here is actually h1, but doesn't matter. So this is the range of the horizontal launch, and as you can see, it depends on the speed. Okay, when you have rotation, potential energy, I mean potential energy difference between those two points, potential energy will go into kinetic energy of translation plus kinetic energy of rotation. So that potential energy will go into mv squared divided by 2 plus e omega squared divided by 2. This is the energy of the rotation. E is in moment of inertia for this cylinder that is mr squared. Or how do you call that? Rotational inertia. We call that moment of inertia, doesn't it? Rotational inertia mr squared. So E is mr squared and V is angular velocity that is connected with the linear velocity. You know, divide those that linear velocity with radius. So potential energy, I mean potential energy difference between those two heights is this much. We'll go into this energy here. And as you can see, mr squared here, and you have squared here, and when you add those two things together, you will get m times v. From this equation, v is square root of pa divided by m. And when I place this v in this equation here, I will get range with rotation. This is v, as you can see, square root of pa divided by m, and this is just standard part of the rotation. So this is when you have rotation. When you don't have rotation, you don't have kinetic energy of rotation. So complete potential energy difference will go into kinetic energy of translation. So second part is even simpler to calculate. So when you find second part, you divide this first part, range with rotation, you divide that with the range without rotation, with range of slide, and you will get the answer for this assignment. I will not show you anymore. You could complete it yourself, or for complete little answer, please follow the link in the description. If you want more of this, please subscribe and tell your friends. Thank you. Bye.